It is Monday, August 3rd, and my name is Parvin Boortje. I am the Chief Customer Officer of SZV and one of the SZV coordinators for the execution of the payroll support plan on behalf of the government of St. Maarten. Before I will start with my presentation, I would like to make an announcement for a next information session. Tomorrow, the Minister of Finance will host a live information session from 4 to 5 p.m. You can ask your questions to the Minister of Finance. You can do so by using the Q&A function of this webinar, and you will find the Q&A buttons located on the right top of your screen. You can also use the email ssrp@sszv.sx to submit your questions to the minister. The topics we are discussing today will be the introduction of the business payroll support plan. This is specifically for those employers that did not apply before. I'll give a quick summary of the SZV employers portal. Then we go over how to prepare your June payroll support, how to submit your June payroll support, the outcome of the application review and how to contact your reviewer, the objection procedure, some other conditions that are new, and the key takeaways. So let's get started. For those employers that are new, I would like to give a highlight of the business payroll support. In order to comply with the stimulations of the financial support from the Netherlands, adjustments has been made to the program for payroll stimulus support for the month of June. The general goal of business payroll support stays the same: to support businesses that are facing revenue losses due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and to assist in the prevention of layoffs. The government of St. Maarten will provide eligible employers with payroll support for their employees. The role of the SZV in this is that our institution has been entrusted by the government of St. Maarten to execute the COVID-19 stimulus payrolls plan on behalf of government. Let us now go over to the SZV employers portal. Employers that would like to apply for payroll support must have an active account for the SZV employers portal. If you do not have an account, visit our website sszv.sx and click on the button employers portal. To register for an account, you need a company's SZV number, a digital copy of a valid St. Maarten ID card or passport of the director, and a valid copy of the Chamber of Commerce excerpt. This copy cannot be older than 6 months. The employer's portal is actually your virtual SZV office. All your SZV administration is registered and processed here. I'm talking about the ZVOV declarations, employee mutation forms, your digital archive of submitted documents, and more features are to be added in the future. You can also add your accountant or administrative staff as a user as well. One of the next functionalities that I would highlight here is the possibility to obtain your receipts via the portal, the so-called e-receipts. Using the portal eliminates the need to come to the SZV office. The employer portal is your virtual SZV office. Some tips while you are using the employer's portal. All digital copies that are uploaded, be it a scan in PDF format or a picture in JPEG format, must be in one file. The attachments cannot be larger than 4 MB. The best user experience we guarantee with Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge, or Firefox as a browser. Please do not use Safari. Safari is the standard web browser for Mac products and Apple products. Please switch over to Chrome, Edge, or Firefox. Use a desktop or a laptop. Please do not use your phone or a tablet, as we have experienced that parts of the screens will not be visible when you're using a mobile device. Make sure to check your junk mail for confirmation emails, especially when it is the first time you are receiving an email. Make sure that the email that you are receiving from the employer's portal are whitelisted and will be delivered to your inbox the next time. In case you get the message "fail to submit" on the portal, check if all the mandatory documents are uploaded and if they also meet the conditions as mentioned before. Now you have set up your SZV Employers Portal account and you will be able to prepare your application. Preparing your June application involves the following steps. Make sure that all your employees are confirmed. Check this in the employment overview of the portal. Please update your employment overview if this is needed. Did you declare and pay your ZV and OV declarations? Check this in the review declaration section. If you did not declare and pay as yet, send in your ZVOV declaration via the portal and make your payment using the payment reference that you have received from the portal. You can use that payment reference to make your premium payments. Did you declare and pay your monthly turnover taxes? Have a scanned copy of your monthly turnover tax ready. This includes your declaration form and a copy of your payment confirmation. Please make sure the company bank information is still correct. This must be a bank on the Dutch side of St. Maarten. And a reminder, SZV will always pay in guilders. Make sure that the employee and employer agreement is downloaded and signed by all your employees. A little bit more on the employee and employer agreement, because this is a new requirement that is applicable in the June application. Your employment overview needs to be updated before you can download it. So make sure that the employment overview is completely up to date, and then you will be able to download the employee and employer agreement in the application. This agreement comes pre-filled with all the names of your employees. Is this listing incorrect? Go back to the employment overview and make sure that everything is in order. The agreement uses the data that you have submitted in the employment overview. That is why it's very important your employment overview is up to date. Once you have downloaded the agreement, all your employees must sign after their name. The scanned copy of the signed agreement needs to be uploaded as one file. So scan this as one file and then upload it to the employer portal. Some important reminders. The result of the agreement you made with your employees regarding the 20% employee contribution does not have to be updated as an SZV mutation. Reason for this is that this is a one-time employee contribution and does not reflect in the gross salaries. The agreements between employer and employee are not applicable to ZVOV law and currently are only a requirement of the business payroll support plan for the month of June. Once you have already closed your June payroll, you can still apply. You may make a correction to the payroll that is still open. In that case, make sure that you explain your employees the differences that they will see in their upcoming payslip. Once you have completed these preparations, we will now go over to the actual submission of the form via the portal. I have gathered some print screens for you where we can walk through the different steps of the June application. First of all, where to find the form. Once you open your employer portal, you will see the blue navigation bar on the left side. There you will see C19 stimulus application. Press on that and this screen will open. Make sure you are in the June payroll, because that one is open and you will be able to fill in the June application. Some of the fields come pre-filled in the form. For example, your main activity, the third-party authorization, and bank information. This pre-filled information needs still to be reviewed by you. We use the data that you provided us based on previous applications. If this information has changed, please make the changes. Once you start filling in the form, you may save the info and return if you do not have the completed information at hand. Here you will find an example of the Save Info button, which is highlighted in yellow. Once you come back to the application, you will see the application with the information you have submitted so far, and then you can continue. Once everything is in order, you may use the Submit Application button. Like I mentioned before, there are some pre-filled fields, such as the main activity, already filled in fields, such as the authorized contact person and banking information. Again, I would like to emphasize that you still need to review this information and make corrections if necessary. There are a few fields where you need to upload documents. For example, the turnover tax declaration and the payment receipt. A reminder again, make sure it is one file document that you will upload. You will not be able to separately upload the declaration and the payment. Make sure that you check the boxes where you agree to the terms and conditions. And a very important, upload the employee agreement, which must be signed and uploaded in one complete file for us to review. Then you click Submit, and that completes your application. In case you want to leave some notes and remarks concerning your application, or you feel you made a mistake, please use the notes and remarks section that I've highlighted here for you. You can send in a message to the review team and save the info. Another option to communicate with your reviewer is to use the correspondence section. You will find the correspondence section on top of your application, and I have added a screenshot for you here. You may indicate what needs to be corrected, and you can upload attachments as well. Please use the Compose Message button in the June application. Don't forget to switch over to the June application, because that is what we currently are reviewing. Once the review team opened up your application, they will also communicate with you via this same section. Once the reviewer leaves you a message, you will also get an email that a message is waiting for you in the correspondence section. So you can always go back to the employer's portal, open the June application, and check the correspondence section for the messages that the review team left you. As soon as SZV made a decision, this decision is also visible for you in the employer's portal. That is the next sheet. Here you will find two scenarios. The first scenario, where you will find a green bar, is when your application has been approved. There you will find two links to click on. The first link is View Decision Letter. There you will find the decision letter and the arguments that the decision is based on. You will also find payment specifications. Here you will find the Excel sheet, which indicates the specification of the approved payroll support amount. Please take note of the Submit Objection button that we have created here as well. I will get back to that in a few, but it's important to see that the Submit Objection button is located here in this green bar. For rejected applications, you will find a similar bar, being it in red. In the red bar, you will find the decision letter and the arguments why the application was rejected. You will also find the Submit Objection button, which you can use to submit your objection letter. In case you do not agree with the decision taken, you may protest this. You use the buttons I just showed you, which is the, let me go back one time so I can show you again. You will use the Submit Objection buttons to submit your objection. Once you've done that, your screen will look like this. You find the letter of objection here on the left side of the application. It also says view your letter of objection. So you can double check if your objection letter was correctly uploaded. In case the objection committee approved your objection, you can also see the outcome of the objection committee. That button is called View Objection Outcome. Once you click on that, you will find the results of the deliberations from the objection committee. A new decision will also be visible concerning the request. I would like to highlight some other conditions that are new in the June payroll support plan. As part of the application for the June payroll support plan, you as an employer agree that the name of your company will be published on internet, the newspaper, and in the official publication of the government, the Landskrant. If the employer, in addition to payroll support of June, also received payroll support for the months of April and May, this will be published as well in SAP Media. The deadline to submit your June application form is Friday, August 14th. In short, you must have an active employer portal account. For the purpose of applying to the June business payroll support, you do not have to update the employee mutations to reflect the agreements that you made with your employees regarding their 20% contribution. This is seen as a separate agreement, and gross salaries remained unchanged. Be sure that all your digital documents are legible. When required, be sure that multiple documents are uploaded as one digital file. Your deadline to submit is Friday, August 14th. Questions about your submitted application can be asked via the portal, via the Compose message function, like I just discussed, or by emailing ssrp@sszv.sx. I would like to close my presentation with an overview of some useful links. For more information and the official guidelines pertaining to the June payroll application, please visit ssrp.sx/junepayrollsupport. For access to the SZV Employers Portal, you may access sZV.sx and then you will navigate to the Employer Portal. There is a separate button for that. Any questions, you may post them in the Q&A section of this webinar or email them to ssrp@sZV.sx. We have come to the end of this presentation. I would like to take some questions now via the Q&A section of the webinar. This requires me to log out of this presentation and open up the webinar. So bear with me for one moment. Okay. One of the questions that was asked is, if an employee does not sign the 20% agreement, does this mean the employer will not receive payroll support for just them or for all employees? The answer to this question is, if one employee does not sign the agreement, the employer would not be eligible for payroll support. It is therefore very important that all your employees agree with the 20% contribution. One of the questions is also, what happens to the objections which were emailed to the portal? Some objections from previous months were uploaded already by our administration team to the portal. You can check this by opening up your previous month application and see if your objection letter is visible to you already. If this has not been the case, please feel free to submit your objection letter still, because you can still submit your objection letters for the month of April and May. Another question is about minimum wage earners. Are minimum wage earners exempted for contributing 20%? That is correct. They are exempted. And let me publish this so you can read with me. Hold on. The question was, what if a few employees are making minimum wage and the others are above minimum wage? So you have to look at it individually. Those that are on the minimum wage are exempted to make their contribution. Those that are above minimum wage have to make their contribution with the maximum of the minimum wage. So they cannot contribute more than their minimum wages. One of the other questions that I have received. I see some individual questions that are very specific. I choose to answer some questions that are more general so that more employers can benefit from the answer. One of the questions is, if an employer If an employee agrees with a 20% contribution, does this mean that the employee agrees to work for 100%? So this is more a labor question, which needs to be discussed between employer and employee. On the part of business payroll support, we look at the 20% contribution. The regulation leaves it between employer and employee to come to an agreement what the working hours are. So it is important for payroll support that the 20% contribution has been made. This can also be made by giving in working hours. So if that is the agreement, the employee should not work for full 100%. But again, that is a very individual question, and it depends on what the agreement is between employer and employee. Okay, one of the other questions. So with regards to the questions, let me repeat that one more time. We take note of all the questions that come in, and in the webinar tomorrow by the minister, we will also use some of these questions for the Q&A session there. So if you do not get your answer from me, we will forward those to the minister for his Zoom session tomorrow. One of the questions is, payroll need to remain 100%. Yes, the intention is that payroll remains 100%. Do employees on the minimum wage listed in the template agreement also should sign the agreement with 20% reduction? No, they should not. And you may write there that they are on minimum wage. We will check that with our records. If June and July payroll are already closed, can the employer make the correction of the 20% in the August payroll? Yes, they can. One of the most common questions that we get, what happens if some of or all of the employees do not agree to take the 20% employee part? I've answered that a little bit earlier. If one or all of the employees do not agree to take the 20% employee part, the employer will not be eligible for payroll support. Do you need a stamp copy of your turnover tax declaration? The answer is yes. Must payment receipts supporting the declared turnover tax declaration be part of the updated files? The answer is yes. Can the employer allow the employees to work 20% less in order to make up for the 20% contribution? Yes, the employer is allowed to have the workers work 20% less. Some have questions about employees that are or are not in service anymore and if they should still apply. This all depends on how the registry is. Your registry should reflect the current situation. So the system will automatically include or exclude the employees. Once you do not feel this is according to what it should be, you should write an objection letter so we can review the situation. The questions regarding the calculations, I would like to collect those and offer to the minister for his Zoom session tomorrow. So he will be able to answer that in more detail. I have answered the questions that were geared towards the use of the SHV portal. If we missed some, we will make sure that we publish the Q&As via the SSRP website. We have a list of Q&As there, and we will continue to add questions that are coming in. So that is an important link for you to bookmark for these upcoming weeks, so you can always check and go back to the SSRP.sx website, because that is your source of information. We have come to the end of this webinar. And many also have asked if a recording is available. And yes, the recording of this session is available when you click on the invitation link. Have a good afternoon. Stay healthy and stay safe. I thank you for your attention, and I'll see you tomorrow in the information session with the Minister of Finance. Bye-bye for now.